Hello my dear students, I am again with you all and today we'll start with the next chapter of English literature and that is a poem and it is very interesting and nice poem. I hope you all will like it. The name of the poem or the title of the poem is The Peddler's Caravan and it is written by W.B. Rents. So first, I'll read out the poem before you and I'll explain you the poem as well or I'll give you a short summary about a poem. So let's start reading with the poem. The title of the poem is The Peddler's Caravan and it is composed by W.B. Rents. I wish I lived in a caravan with a horse to drive. Like the peddler man. Where he comes from nobody knows, or where he goes to, but on he goes. His caravan has windows too, and a chimney of tin that the smoke comes through. He has a wife with a baby brown, and they go riding from town to town. Cheers to men and delf to sill. He clashes the basins like a bell. Tea trays, baskets range in order, plates with the alphabet round the border. The roads are brown and the sea is green, but his house is just like a bathing machine. The world is round and he can write, rumble and splash to the other side. With the peddler man, I should like to roam and write a book when I come home. All the people would read my book, just like the travels of Captain Cook. Now children, come to the explanation of poem. It is a very easy poem and it is written by W.B. Rents. Firstly, I am going to tell you something about the poet, that is William Brighty Rents. He was born on 1823. He was a prolific and versatile writer in several areas. He is mostly remembered now for his many children's verses, but his largest output was probably in the field of essays, especially for children. The Peddler's Caravan and Great, wide, beautiful, wonderful world are still known and loved by several generations. Now children, come to the poem. The Peddler's Caravan by William Brighty Rents describes the speaker's longing to live the life of a peddler man on the road. Now children, peddler man is a person who travels from place to place, trying to sell something, usually small objects. In the first stanza, the poet introduces the speaker's longing for a life of travel. Here, poet tells about the speaker's wish to live in a caravan. Now children, caravan is a large vehicle where you can sleep, cook, etc. When you are traveling or on holiday. In the same way, speaker's caravan is pulled by a horse. Where he goes and where he comes, his destinations seems very exciting and fresh. In the second stanza, poet describes that his caravan has windows too and a chimney of tin. Now children, what is the meaning of chimney? Chimney is a pipe which takes the smoke into the air. And he roams with his wife and baby from town to town. In the third stanza, the poet describes his trade. Trade means business, as mainly in housewares like chairs to mend, tea trays, etc. In the fourth stanza, the poet compares the peddler's home to a bathing machine, the movement and motion that mirrors the rumble of the caravan over the roads as he travels. In the last stanza of the poem, the speaker's wish to travel with the peddler man so that he could write a book about, like the travels of Captain Cook. So children, I hope you all will like it, like this poem. Thank you so much.